You join me this time over here at the table saw, where I'm going to be making some cross-cut sleds. In this video and the video which will be coming to you in a week's time, I'm going to be making two different cross-cut sleds. Both cross-cut sleds really are very simple, but they are great tools for cutting 90 degree angles onto pieces of stock here at the table saw. And this time I'm going to be starting with this panel cutting sled. So for this sled, I'm going to be using this piece of furniture panel, and the only reason for that is that I have loads of this stuff knocking about from an old piece of furniture which we had, but it should remain reasonably stable. And the nice thing about this is that because of the melamine coating, it should actually run quite smoothly across the surface of the table. But of course, if you wanted to, you could use birch plywood or even MDF. I've just milled up this hardwood for the runner, and I'm not particularly sure what species it is, but it seems to be fairly dense, and it's actually got a kind of waxy feel to it, so it should run fairly smoothly in the mitre slots. If we take a closer look here, you can see that the runner sits just fractionally below the surface of the table, and that way when it's joined to the sled it won't actually rest against the bottom of the mitre slot, and it should reduce some of the friction. I'm just using a few pieces of tissue paper to shim up the runner so that it's flush to the table surface. Now I'm just applying a thin bead of CA glue to temporarily attach the panel to the runner, and I can just drop the panel on top of the runner. And here you can see that I've used the front of the table saw just to help me mount the panel at least reasonably square. With the sled flipped over, I can fix the runner in place with a few screws. Next up is the fence, and because the primary use for this sled is to cut panels, the fence doesn't need to be very tall. One thing that I've done to this fence is to plane a small chamfer against the bottom edge of the fence, and that should avoid small chips of wood from skewing registration against the fence. To go ahead and attach the fence, I've started out by just roughly placing it where I need it. And I'm just going to drive a single screw up here near the saw blade. Next, to align the fence, I'm going to use my large framing square, which I find works the best for this. And I'm just going to butt it up against the saw blade and hold it against the fence. And because I've got a single screw at this end, I can pivot it to where it's just right. And when I think I've got it just there, I can drive the next screw along. With that screw in now, I'm just checking to make sure that it's still square, and if it's not, you will need to remove that screw, pre-drill for another screw, and try again. As far as I can tell, it is pretty good along the length of the square, and it is tight up against the saw blade, so I'm going to finish off by sinking this screw at the end. Now I'm ready to go ahead and perform a few test cuts. The 5-cut test is actually a really great way to ensure that your crosscut sled is cutting nice and square. And if you haven't heard of the 5-cut test and want to learn more about it, I've posted a few links down in the description to other videos which will tell you more about it. To finish off the sled, I'm just sinking about 6 screws from the underside to make sure the fence really doesn't go anywhere. There we go, folks. That's really all there is to this panel cutting sled. Be sure to like this video before you leave, as well as subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't done so already. Take care, everyone. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.